Economic problems are throwing the personal plans of millions of older Americans off course. Here's the fast draw team of Josh Landis and Mitch Butler.
Retirement, that time when you cast off financial worries and set sail for new horizons.
When all of those years of hard work finally pay off. American families planned for a long time, and their sea of retirement assets swelled to $8.8 trillion.
Then the stock market sank, and so did their fortunes. More than $3 trillion in retirement assets evaporated.
Running retirement plans aground, sending retirees back to work, and postponing future retirement plans. Here's the latest estimate. The number of workers over the age of 65 will rise 80% in the coming years. And more than 6% of America's workforce will be working past the traditional age of retirement. Might not sound like it, but that's a lot.
Not exactly what they expected, but we wanted to find something positive in all this. Researchers have made some surprising discoveries. Here are a few. Psychologists at Cornell University found retired men who returned to work had higher morale and lower levels of depression. Men who chose to go back to work part-time reported the highest level of happiness. Turns out this was especially true if their wives were able to stay at home. Here's another one. Researchers found people who retired early were more likely to die early, and those who worked until they were older didn't shorten their lifespan at all.
Health problems explain some, but not all of this phenomenon. While that's probably some consolation to those who find themselves back on the job, a lot of folks would probably rather be back on the good ship retirement. We wanted to find out how unretired retirees could make the best of their current situation. Andrew Tegnanelli is a financial advisor who says first thing to do is streamline the family budget. Even though nest eggs are smaller, they might still be enough to get by.
Now they don't have as much a safety cushion, but you know, really the numbers aren't pointing to as bad or bleak a scenario as what they were thinking it was. It could be just misperception.
And if they do have to return to work, he says, remember, it's temporary.
There will come a day, 2011, 2012, maybe even 2010, that you will start to get the recovery.
So don't give up the ship just yet. At least there are some benefits for retirees who go back to work.
While waiting for that tide to turn and a good strong wind, back in the sails.